Okay, we're going to be talking about the emotion of happiness, joy, celebration, jubilation. And this song is certainly going to be no exception, as it is literally called Celebration. This song in particular, I like as an example because the big feeling is going to be that of celebration. However, there's going to be some more complex feelings involved because it's about celebrating the life of somebody who passed as opposed to mourning their death. So we're going to be tucking more complex feelings like that of something spiritual and also something that is comforting into this. So big umbrella celebration, but also spirituality and comfort. So let's give it a listen and then let's start to break down some ideas.
No quiero que traigan flores, trae un gancho de la label y una caja de blones, una libre marihuana y que pongan todas mis canciones. Todo el mundo vacilando, arriba los blones. Todo el barrio fiesta, hoy todo el mundo se amanece, aquí nadie se acuesta.
So, when we think of happiness, a lot of the ideas that should come to mind are brighter tones, things that are exciting and surprising, things that are very danceable and groovy, things that are inviting. And especially with the idea of this trying to be a comforting song, we want to have warmth and fullness and softness to it. And with the spiritual side of things, we want some kind of like spiritual glow. We are going to want maybe some reverbs that remind us of things that are churchy or something like that, or elements that remind us of churches, stuff like that. So these ideas are going to come together to evoke the feeling of happiness without necessarily being explicit about it. So listening to this, going into the music bed, there's definitely a few things in there that we can tie together and really iron out to make really feel happy. So right away, this little string horn thing. To me, that's this very quintessential fanfare-ish kind of string sound, and I think having the brighter overtones of that really emphasized, or the drama of it really emphasized, is going to definitely help make this feel celebratory. So the very first thing I want to tackle here is this string. One thing that I want to try is just bringing up the drama of the string, and that's going to be using this earth EQ right here. It's going to bring up the very deep low end, and I'm going to really crank this thing and hope that I can get something really dramatic and cool feeling out of it. Now, because there's not a lot of low end, and because of just the nature of this EQ, it looks like I'm really turning this thing up a lot. I've got it literally as high as it's going to go, but it's turning up stuff from the sub range, and this just doesn't have anything in the sub range, so it's not actually doing that much. It's just making the low end bolder, which I like. The next thing I'm going to do is bring in this custom EQ series, and just the nature of this EQ, it has a sort of tone and saturation that occurs even without doing any EQ, and that's going to sort of embolden the flavor of this sound as well. It's subtle, but it sparks a little bit more and it speaks up a little bit. Now I'm going to go into that upper mid-range, maybe into this like dead center mid-range, around 800 or around 2K, and I'm going to find what makes this sound really exciting in a happy way. Not necessarily in a come-at-your-face kind of way, but in this kind of like brightening up sort of way, like almost like opening your eyes really wide. That's not bad, but it feels a little aggressive, so maybe it's not really what we want. That to me feels more celebratory because we've gone to this higher tone. It doesn't have as much edge in the attack of the string. Too much of that edge is going to make it feel too much like it's trying to come at you, and that's not really what I want from this sound. Similarly, this 800 hertz might be a little bit much. I think that it's kind of giving it too much power, and I'm not looking for power. Again, I'm looking for something that's more inviting, that's more comforting. So I'm going to try 400 hertz and see how that feels. Yeah, I like that, especially because it gives that first upswing hit a little bit more presence. So let's hear it in context of the mix now. Nice. nice. Yeah, that feels good. It feels uplifting when we hear that string, and that's what we're going for. Okay, so now let's take a look at some of these other elements here that are making up the main body of the music bed. So we have this church organ. And I really like the bounce of it. I think that that's really cool. I also really just like the fact that it's a church organ, because when I think of funerals, I think of churches. They go hand in hand. It's going to bring in that spiritual element, and I think that that's going to help quite a bit. So maybe I want to bring out some of the bounce and some of the presence of this particular element. Now we also have this piano. I love the reverb that's already printed into this piano. It has such a sparkle and shine to it. It's so sweet sounding that I think the sweetness of it is going to speak to the sweetness of loving somebody who's been lost. And I think that the glow and sparkle of it is going to also have that bit of angelic sense. And since I'm getting that from the piano, and I feel like I'm getting all of that better from the piano, I actually favor the piano a little bit more than the church organ here personally. So I'm going to mute these other elements, these other musical elements, so that we're really just down to the drums and this piano. And I'm going to set the piano first, because I think that that's going to be more important to getting what I'm looking for. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to really iron out that attack and sustain of the piano, because I feel like right now it feels a little bit thin to me. It's sitting right in a way, but it could have a little bit more of that glow, and it could have a little bit more of that bounce to it. So I'm going to use the FG Bomber, and this is a plugin that can certainly be misused to make something very aggressive when that's not the intention. But if I can find just the right vibe for it, I'm going to be able to get more of everything in a really pleasing way. I'm going to set it to 50% because I think that's more reasonably where I'm going to set it. And then I'm going to go between the two in the mix, and I'm going to see what speaks to me a little bit more. I like present mode better. I think that it's bringing out the shimmer part of it, and it feels softer, and I'm getting more of that angelic quality that I was looking for. Okay, great. So now I'm going to find a level for the church organ that feels right. I'm also going to try experimenting with a little bit of reverb here, because I do want it to have that sort of churchy sound. And I definitely have a few options for that, but I think I'm going to start by looking for something that's specifically church-oriented, like the Lex Large Church. I'm using this attack control to slow down the onset of the reverb, which is going to help keep the attack of the notes clean. And because this is such a bouncy part, I want to make sure that the attack of the notes are pretty clean. And I think I can exaggerate the width a little bit too. Yeah, that feels pretty nice.